The Miami Dolphins fanbase entered Miami Week 2 home opener coming off a big division win in Week 1, but the Buffalo Bills reminded them we aren't that good. The Dolphins gave up sack after sack after sack to unblocked edge rushers, and after the Bills' first two drives ended in touchdowns, the rout was on. Miami defense held strong into the mid-third quarter before they simply couldn't make up for the ineptitude of the Dolphins' offense. Buffalo added a couple of more touchdowns while the Dolphins' offense sputtered. Fans on social media were laughing at the two-headed offensive coordinator system that looks just as bad as the Chan Gailey offense from last year. When Eric Studsville and George Godsey were not the target, Chris Greer and his wasted first-round draft picks were. Greer and Flores have spent first-round picks on Austin Jackson and Noah Igbinoghene while taking Jalen Waddle over Penei Sewell. To say nothing of wasted picks in other rounds. Miami offensive line was the biggest issue in today's blowout loss. It was so bad that fans were exiting the stadium with almost 12 minutes still left in the game. The victory by the Bills is the seventh win in a row and brings Bill coach Sean McDermott's record against Miami to 8-1. Brian Flores has yet to beat his division rival. Despite a decent game, given the offensive play, the defense held up well. But four quarters of football with an offense that can't move the ball is just too taxing on a defense in this heat. Miami drops to 1-1 and finds themselves tied with the Patriots and Bills for the division. The Dolphins need to figure out their offensive line issues, and they need to do it quickly. Today's loss is the second blowout loss to the Bills. The 35-0 loss is only marginally better than the 2020 season finale blowout loss of 56-26. The shutout is the largest margin of victory by the Bills when shutting out Miami dating back to 1966, Miami's first year in the league.